Welcome back to my channel if you are returning, and welcome if you are new. I'm Jabulile, aka Malushaba, and this is Rural Life and Sustainable Living. Guys, I'm still trying to find the proper place where I can like comfortably record videos, because I tried indoors and indoors is not working. The lighting is so bad. If I manage to fix it and I find a proper spot in the house to whereby I can record my videos, I'm gonna do it there, because outside it gets a little bit too busy outside. There are people passing, there are dogs barking everywhere because they are pigs. Somebody let loose their pigs and the dogs are going wild. I'm sure you can hear them. So it gets a little bit distracting, you know. Unlike KZN, we're a little bit hidden, like you couldn't really see what was going on, you know, on my side of the world. So it was easy for me to record videos here. It's a little bit tricky to record videos outside, but we're gonna fix it, we're gonna figure it out, and we'll see what we can do with this situation. In today's video, I want to talk about buying this land in this area. I don't want to say buying land in Limpopo, because buying land in Limpopo can be different according to the different places. And it's not like KZN, where the land is under the Ngonyama Trust. The most of the rural lands are under Ngonyama Trust, so it's kind of like the same everywhere, so to speak, with just differences here and there. Generally things are the same, but here things are different. So I want to tell you basically about this particular area and how much we bought this land for. So basically we bought this land in 2013, if not 2014, but I would like to say it's 2013 if my memory serves me well. It's two stands, so we bought two stands basically. So it's one plot, but it comprises of two plots that have been made one. And one, if my memory serves me well, it's supposed to be 30 by 30. So and then today what I did, I checked on Google Earth just to make sure, just to take the measurements, and it said it's about 2,400 square meters, the size of the land. And we bought each stand for 5,500 rands, and then together that made it 11,000 rands for the stands. And then now each stand is worth about 25,000 to 30,000 rand, so together they would be about 50,000 rand basically. So since it's one plot, let's just say it's 50,000 rand. But I want to give you each stand so that you kind of understand if you're going to buy one stand, because they sell one, and then if you want more than one, then you buy more than one. So one stand is going for about 25,000 to 30,000 rand at this time. What I want to talk about also is some of the questions that you guys asked me. You asked me how would I compare KZN, just the community here and the community in KZN. There are differences, one because culturally two different worlds, but in terms of like the human spirit, I think it's just certain things are just common sense. So my neighbors are kind, my neighbors are helpful, and helpful in the sense that when I was not living here, my neighbors were the ones that were watching my place. You know, if anything funny happened, they would let my parents know that, hey, listen, you know, this and this is happening. And they've helped me quite a number of times, and I'll get into that. My neighbors, the ones that live this side, and I also have neighbors on this side. And then the other ones are a little bit like a little bit further. So otherwise at the back they're still building, and then on this side, as you can see, there isn't, I'm not sure if you can see, actually you probably can't see, but like on this side there's also nobody at the moment. So the neighbors on this side, we only got to know when we were when we came here, but the neighbors on this side, we actually know them from before. It just so happened that we got here and they had also bought land opposite us, which has really worked out so much for us, so well for us, because they were then able to just keep an eye without even having to like drive out of their home. They're literally opposite us, so that's been a blessing. And yeah, and in terms of my other neighbors as well, they're also very nice people. They're very kind. It's an elderly lady with her husband and son, and I found that they're very warm and they've been very welcoming. And so I would say in that aspect of just being people, being kind, people being people, humans to another human, they've been really welcoming and warm, and I've enjoyed having them as neighbors, this side and this side, because there's no neighbors on this side really like that would be close to me. The other ones out there, they've been also very welcoming, but otherwise everyone else is a little bit further. And I told you guys that I also have a water issue. My neighbors a little bit further down, not too far, they're the ones that have been helping us with water. Yeah, long story how they're the ones with water and not the ones closer. It's okay, let me try and explain it, because I don't want this video to be too long. Actually, I'm not gonna talk about that today, because then the video is gonna be too long, and then I think I can talk about that in a different video. But they've also been helpful for, so I would say that in comparison with like KZN, and the community here is different. People are more private, people are more like in their, it's different. And also I want to add that the economics are different as well. So I don't know if because people have cars here, a lot of them have cars, I don't want to make that comparison, but I'm gonna make it. People like keep to themselves a lot, and I don't know if there is something about people having money that, or like people affording certain things, that makes them want to keep to themselves. I don't know. And then people that are less financially abundant, I'll put it like that, for lack of a better word, because I don't want to say poor, because people are not poor in KZN, in rural KZN. People have cattle, people have like, they have livestock, they are happy, they have huge plots, right? They have huge plots, they can plant and they grow stuff, they're good, guys. People in rural areas are wealthy, and it may be that they're not like, in terms of like how in your cities and urban areas people view wealth, like you have a car, you have a huge house, you have this, but I mean if you really think about it, they have debt. And people in rural areas don't have debt, most of them. They just live within their means. And I just find them to be happier. So in comparison, I would say people in KZN, the community in KZN was much more alive and interactive and happy. Regardless, wow, I've actually not sat down and actually thought about it like that. But yeah, they were just happier. And I'm saying they were happier because I could see them, I could interact with them all the time. Whereas here you have to like go knock at somebody's door, and it's not easy also because people have fences around their yards. You don't get that a lot in the community back in KZN. People don't really have fences and gates and things like that. And they don't keep dogs and stuff. So you can't even go to your neighbor's place because there are dogs, you know. Like, for one, I've never been to my neighbor's house, not once, because they have a pit bull and another dog. I'm not sure what breed it is. And guys, I'm terrified of dogs. So we just text, or like we call each other, or like I stand by their fence and just call out and we talk, because I'm not going inside. It's not happening. So there's that. And also they keep indoors, whereas back there my children played, it was easy for them to go like to and fro from one this home to the next home and go play with each other. And because also I never had to worry about that safety element of like, okay, but my neighbor has dogs and they might hurt my children or they might hurt me. So there's those kind of things that are in play. But they are warm people, they are kind people, just not like how it was more interactive. It was more interactive in KZN. And I just think that I don't know if when people have more, they start maybe fearing that maybe people might take their stuff away, and then they now have the need to have fences, huge fences, and walls, huge high walls, and they need dogs, they need cameras, they need all of that. I don't know, guys. I think it's something to talk about. It's something to just kind of look at and ask yourself, like, what could be the deal there? Because I'm trying to figure it out, because hence, like I've already said, that I don't think the community in KZN or in rural areas, I can necessarily say they are poor. Like, there is some level of poverty. I don't want to like be naive about that, or like pretend or seem like I'm pretending to like overlook that. No, there is an element of poverty, yes, because you know there aren't a lot of jobs available in rural areas, or like work opportunities in rural areas like there are in urban areas and cities and stuff like that. But yeah, I think this can be a topic for another day. I think it can be a topic for another day. And also the other thing I perhaps can talk about in a different video is the process of buying itself. The process of buying itself, because I think that will need a different topic. And maybe I can do a comparison on here versus KZN, because yeah, there are differences, and I want to talk about them. So yeah, see you guys in the next video. I hope this video was informative, and I'm stopping because I don't want it to be long, but there's still more that I want to just talk about in terms of just comparing the two. And otherwise, in conclusion, I just want to say that you must know that places are different. So no one place will be like this, like the other. Even in KZN, it might be in KZN, but one rural area can be different from another, and even the community can be different from another. So I don't want you to feel like, oh, so Limpopo is a little bit like this, and you know, in terms of like just the things that I've explained. No, it's not the whole of Limpopo. It's the area where I live. And also you must remember, like I said in the previous, in another video, when I was telling you a little bit about this community or this place where I live, it's mixed race. Okay, it's a rural area, but it's mixed race. So there isn't like one culture. So that also comes into play in terms of like how the community interacts with each other. So that's something to keep in mind. Whereas in KZN, it's mainly Zulu people. It's the same culture. And when you're coming from a different place, you have to kind of integrate yourself into that culture. You have to adapt yourself into that culture. Because, case, it's KwaZulu Natal. KwaZulu Natal. It's one king also. Here, there's different kings and chiefs and stuff like that. Even in KZN, there's different chiefs, but the king is one. And he is umZulu. So here it's different ones. We have Matsonga, we have Bapedi, we have Balobedu, we have Bavenda. See? So it's different. And all these people speak different languages. And even though like Balobedu is in terms of the look at me going on and I said I'm ending this video, but anyways, let us conclude. In the official languages, we have 11 official languages in South Africa. Balobedu is it comes under Sepedi, which is a it's a dialect of Sepedi, but they have their own king, a queen rather. They have the Balobedu have a queen. Sorry for another day. And so Bapedi, the different Bapedi people also have different kings. So see, so it's a whole different dynamic. It's a whole different thing. So yeah, I hope this video was informative, guys. And I hope that I'll be able to dissect all these different things that I've just shared with you guys and give you a little bit of a better understanding. And yeah, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's vibrant, you know, just to live in a country that is as diverse as ours is. It's actually awesome. And coming back home has reminded me of that. And it's been a beautiful, pleasant experience. For me, one of those things is just being able to come back again and speak Xitsonga almost full time, because when you don't use something, you forget it, you lose it, and are starting to forget certain words. And even now, when I speak to somebody that speaks Xitsonga, I have to kind of like, okay, what is that word? What is that word? And I'm just happy to be here and be able to use my tongue in that way again and remember those words and just add more to my vocabulary. And even Kilobedu, just hearing, it's like music to my ears, guys. Just having to, just being able again to speak the different languages. Whereas in KZN, I'm still speaking one language, and then of course at home we're speaking Sesotho as well, because my children's father is Mosotho, so that's the language we spoke at home. Even now, when I speak to my children, we still speak Sesotho at home. But it's just beautiful to just be able to switch, you know, languages with this one and that. It's, guys, I'm so my heart is warm. My heart is warm, and yeah. See you in the next video.